This is another case of infertility in young female, referred by gynecologist for proper diagnosis. Patient has history of scanty menstruation and amenorrhea, and sometime gave history of menstruation only with medication. Only one blood test was available, in which FSH was raised. FSH is a hormone produced by anterior pituitary gland in the brain and stimulates a dominant follicle in the ovary to grow. A higher level of FSH may indicate that the brain is trying to compensate for ovaries that are behaving older. Uterus is normal in this case, but endometrium is thin, 5.5 mm. Left ovary is visualized. Volume is 3.4 and size is 28 mm. The both are decreased as compared to normal sizes in this age group. Sizes and measurements are written in this video. Right ovary is also decreased in size and volume. No growing follicles seen in both ovaries on 14th day of scan. There are small immature follicles or antral follicles of size 1 to 2 mm, approximate 8 in number in both ovaries. Antral follicle count is measured at 2 to 4 days of menstruation, but can be measured at any day of the menstrual cycle. This is a case of decreased ovarian reserve, the normally which decreases as the patient ages above 40 years of age. This can present at any age, but mostly there is no apparent any cause of the condition. Some other causes are radiation therapy, smoking, pelvic infection, autoimmune disorders, mumps, genetic abnormalities, tubal disease, endometriosis, previous ovarian surgery, and chemotherapy. Patient has difficulty in getting pregnancy. Patient has late or absent menstrual periods or shorter menstrual cycle than average. Patient may have miscarriages. Important blood tests include FSH level to increase and AMH level to decrease. Now important question is it still possible to get pregnancy with decreased ovarian reserve? There is no good response of treatment in every patient. Only about 30% of patients are able to get pregnancy with their own eggs after receiving treatment. And these most of the cases depend on early diagnosis and early treatment. There are some other possibilities. If decreased ovarian reserve is diagnosed, it is possible to freeze healthy eggs for future use. Another option is using donor's egg to get pregnancy. The eggs will then be fertilized through IVF in own patient's uterus or uterus of the surrogate. TVS scan is required to diagnose on ultrasound, and the aim is to diagnose decreased ovarian reserve as early as possible so that the patient can get pregnancy with her own eggs after treatment.